So today I want to show you how to add USD file into our RealityKit scene and use it in visionOS. Keep in mind that this is just an Xcode 15 beta, so there could be some changes in the final version. So first of all, we need to create a new app. Let's call it Flying Dragon. I will explain later. You will also see. As an initial scene, we have a window. You can read about immersive space and the volume initial scene on the Apple documentation page. So for now, we don't care about initial space, immersive space, just
Created.
all right. So first of all, you see the navigation split view. It's just an example app with some model 3D generated on the right. So this is a sphere, and this sphere is in the RealityKit content package. So RealityKit content is a place where you can put yours USD models and so on, generated by for example Blender. So for now, let's just open Reality Composer Pro, where we can see our sphere. And we have our scene. And what I would like to do here is just pick my custom animation, my custom model, 3D model, dragon animation flying, which I found. And as you can see, its animation is performed here. And what I need to do is just drag the object into mine scene. So let's remove the sphere for now. And as we can see, the dragon is a bit too much. So let's change the scale for it. Let's set it to 0.1. Okay. Let's make it also a little below the our area. Okay. Okay. We can save it with just pressing save all. And let's back to Xcode and let's see how it goes. So we have a model 3D which is available in RealityKit Swift UI, and we have the bundle RealityKit. Okay, let's see. Okay, of course the preview will not work, but let's just run the visionOS simulator. Okay, again. Okay, we don't see anything yet. So let's just adjust our source code to that. So first of all is we need to take care of the button for displaying our dragon and animating it. Just a quick explanation here. We have a button here with just some text from High Valyrian, just a comment fly, which is triggering the start animation boolean value. And we also have here a RealityView. RealityView is a content inside where you can just load your entity, right? So in our example, we will load just a dragon there. And what I would like to do is just hide it for a second after loading. just to wait for the action from the button, then it should appear. So is enabled is the same like is hidden is in SceneKit. So basically the entity will be loaded, but it will be not displayed yet, not visible for the user. And we have also another callback from the reality view, which is update. And then you can perform any task like, for example, getting the dragon entity. In our example, we will just take the first because we know that in the scene there is only one entity. But if you would have multiple entities, you will probably get something like filter, or you could find also using find entity, which I cannot find right now, but it's available there. Yes, so first of all, you just if you find the dragon, you will start to show it, and then you will show you want to perform the animation. The animation will not start automatically, you need to trigger it. So each USD file has can have a lot of animations. So the best way to perform all of them, because the materials could be split and so on, is just perform for each of them the same animation. Keep in mind that you need, if you want to have an animation some defined amount of times, or just perform it in infinite way, you need to write also here a repeat function. Without it, the animation will perform only once and then it will stop. Okay, so the transition is like from the post version state, it will trigger in 3 seconds to the animation. You will see how it will look, because the dragon initial position is different from the animated one. Okay, so let's try it. Okay, in visionOS I need to change to interaction mode. Yeah, as I think that the dragon was there, but it was too big for the scene. So let's try to improve it. Let's stop for a second. So let's open the USD file, and you can see that this dragon is still too big. Even the scale is 0.1. Keep in mind that RealityKit Composer Pro is a new thing, and there is an issue that if you will just, you know, change the scale to 0.01, it will not apply. So what we can do here is just in the code, when we are loading our entity here, let's make it assigned to entity variable. Let's return it here. And inside there is a function set scale, which will just be setting what was possible to set in the Reality Composer Pro. We can set it programmatically. Yeah, okay. So let's give it a try now. Okay, so as you can see, the animation behaves properly. It was starting from the bottom to top because the animation is defined this way. Of course, in the tools like Blender, we can adjust it, change the animation. For now, it would be really hard to change it using some programming inside RealityKit. But what we can do is just open the Reality Composer Pro and then we can just make it a little bit smaller, I mean not smaller, but put it beneath the ground zero. Okay, let's try something like this. So okay, let's save it, let's run. Okay, a little more. Save it. You need to always save it if you would like to have the newest version inside the project. Okay, still. Okay, looks better. We can take a look that it's a 3D model. So if you are interested in please follow me. Probably I will show you more videos about visionOS and RealityKit. So thank you very much for your attention.